for those who don't know me, I first just wanted to say I miss and love you all so much, and I hope you and your family are staying safe during this time. So a little bit about me is I went through recruitment as a sophomore. I cheered for Western my freshman and sophomore year, so I didn't really know if sorority and Greek life would be for me, but a girl named Abby Fouch, who used to be an ADPI, convinced me to go through recruitment, and I'm so glad she did because I ended up here being surrounded by the best possible sisters I could ask for. I am so glad I went ADPI, and ADPI has brought me nothing but good memories and positive experiences and friendships that I know will last a lifetime. I would say my favorite experience in ADPI is definitely Shenanigans, the year we won with Kim Possible. It was freaking awesome and so much fun. I also loved doing spring sing and participating in Greek Week. I really wish I would have run for a bigger position and lived in the house, so I encourage each one of you guys to get involved while you can and get connected, because it'll definitely be worth it. I could go on and on and give a bunch of shout outs, but I don't want to get in my feels, but I will talk about a few of my besties that I've met along the way in ADPI. So I'll start off with Casey. You have seriously been my number one girl since we met on bid day and we took our first picture together. Little did we know we'd become best friends, and I'm so glad that Stacia and Lynn wanted us to be friends, because look where we ended up. You are such a leader in ADPI, and I know you're going to do big things. You've already done big things. You're a role model to me. You make me feel special. You make everyone around you feel special. You are such an important person, and you are so loved, and I'm forever grateful for this friendship, and I know it's going to last forever. To my little Maddie, I love you so much, you little firecracker. Little did I know what I was getting into whenever I got you as a little. You bring me so much joy, so much happiness. You are just a crazy little self, but I love you forever. And I want you to know how loved you are by me and how special you are and how much joy you bring to me. And never forget that. And I'll always be your mom, and I love you forever. And to my grand littles, you better take care of her because she deserves the world. To my Kinsey girl, I don't know what I would have done without you in nursing school. You were my rock throughout that whole process, and I couldn't have done it without you. And I'm so glad ADPI and nursing school brought us together and brought us this sweet friendship, and I'll forever be grateful for that. And I'm so proud of you. You get to be a nursery nurse, your dream job. Get a love on all the babies and families, and they're going to be so lucky to have you as a nurse. And to my other two roommates, Leanne and Aubrey, it was so fun living with you guys while it lasted for the 2 or 3 months or whatever, but I'll forever be grateful for those memories that we made together and cherish those. And I miss you guys and hope you guys are doing well and keep being you, because y'all are awesome. And I could keep going on and on and give more shout outs to, you know, Hallie and Chris and Michaela and Mariah and Kate and all of you guys. But you guys know how special you are to me and how important you are to me. And I'm forever grateful for everyone I've met here in ADPI. And I truly encourage each one of you guys to get involved and don't take these years for granted, because they come and go so quick. It has not hit me that I'm a senior and that I'm leaving and now a few weeks, and I'm just forever grateful for this experience and for ADPI. And I really do love you guys and know your worth and know how special you are, and get connected and get involved. Bye, love you all.
Hi friends. I think most people have thought about what they're going to say in their senior speech since the very first time they saw one. Mine, it was like 4 December graduates in the Grice Auditorium. One of them was our former president, Lindsay Ratliff. God bless her. Our second one was our former vice president, Haley Pinnell. And then the other two were girls I've literally never seen before. So, but again, like, I think every time you see one, you're like, oh, I should say that, or oh, I'm going to say this. And honestly, Emma Briggs and I were going to perform a toast to all of our fallen sisters from the class of fall of 16, which was going to take quite a bit of time. So I won't do that here, but, you know, we'll make a list. We'll write something up and send it in Splad. But really, I just wanted to say thank you. To each and every one of you. It certainly hasn't been easy, but it's definitely been the best time of my life. You all have seen me at my best and been there for me at my best, and you've seen me at my worst and been there for me at my worst. It's definitely not been easy, like I said, but I wouldn't trade any part of it. I've made mistakes, I've seen challenges, I've seen you all go through so much as women, and I'm so happy to have been there to see you all come out on the other side of some very difficult things, and to have been there for you, or had the opportunity to be there for you while you did it. And you all did the same thing for me. And so I'm forever grateful to Epsilon Delta. If I think too much about it, I'll cry, so I won't do that. But to each and every one of you, even down to Fall 19, the youngest of the crew, I hope even in just 1 year you've seen what this chapter can do for you. It doesn't have to be every part of your life. It certainly wasn't every part of mine. But what you put into it is what you get out of it, and that's definitely true. A lot of times you have no one to blame but yourself in that scenario. So I love you. I'm going to miss you so much. To everyone who's ever lived in the house with me, to the girlies, to my diamond fam, to everyone who's reached out to me. There's anyone who I've ever done an event with, literally all of you. There's no way to qualify it. It's all of you. So I'm so grateful to call you, each and every one of you, my sisters. And I hope you get to see the impact in yourself that I've gotten to see, through Epsilon Delta.
Hi everyone. I debated even making a video because I was afraid that I might start crying and that would be really awkward with the video delivery, but, I didn't want to leave without saying anything. So, I wrote a little bit on my phone. ADPI has defined my college career. I've made my best memories with the women of ADPI. It's crazy that I'm old now because a lot of the people that impacted me so much, most of y'all never met. ADPI gave me a support system as I entered college. It gave my big, whom I've lived with the last 2 years, and it gave me some of my best friends, three of which I'll be a bridesmaid in their weddings for this year. A shout out to a couple people. Eli, you're truly one of a kind. You inspire me every day, and I love your heart for ADPI. You've made me such a proud big, and I'm happy to leave ADPI in your hands. Leah, thank you for being my dance buddy and the Ryan to my Sharpay, even though we won't get our debut. Emma, we truly are adopted best big and little. Thanks for dancing with me, venturing to Gamma Chi land and back, and for seeing the world with me during my last semester. To my whole fam, you guys have been such a blessing, and I love that you're my legacy in ADPI. Kate, we're more alike than I realized before study abroad, and I'm thankful that that brought us together. Mariah, you're literally the sunshine, and everybody could use you in their life. Donna, thank you for being an oldie with me until the end. ADPI and shenanigans wouldn't have been the same without you. Kelly, you're the sweetest friend, and you're going to make a great nurse. Casey, thank you for being my go-to girl in ADPI. College has never been the same since we met. You always think to include me and get me to go do fun stuff even when I don't want to. You're the life of the party, and I can't wait for you to visit in Nash. There's so many people in this chapter that I could go on about, but really every one of you has had an impact on me in the last 4 years. If I could leave one piece of advice, it would be to go to as much as you can. Don't just make up excuses or take fines. I get that some of the mandatory stuff is dumb, and I skipped a lot my freshman year. It took me until my time at ADPI was coming to an end to realize that these mandatory events and meetings are how I made some of my best friends. Since you're all forced to be there, you don't realize you're making plans or hearing stories and building relationships. But cherish every minute of it because it's over in a flash. Love y'all. See you at homecoming.
Hey guys, I never thought it would be my turn to read one of these speeches, and I certainly never expected them to happen like this. And although I've been sad about college coming to an end, I can't help but be thankful for all of the memories and experiences that I've had over the last 4 years. When I first started my freshman year, I had a lot to figure out. I had just started college in a town where I practically knew no one. Being from Lexington, all the talk at home was how long it was going to take me to transfer back to UK. I gladly stand here today to say that I'm a proud, almost WKU alum. Freshman year, I was in a major that I knew absolutely nothing about, not caring about school and worrying way too much about what my plans were for the weekend. First semester was an eye-opening realization that this whole college thing wasn't just fun and games. My grades were fine first semester, but man, did I need that wake-up call my second semester. Luckily, I got it, thanks to ADPI, and then started my venture over to the business college my sophomore year, and from then on out, it's been smooth sailing. I've always been told that college is the time to make errors, have fun, and figure out who you are as a person, so I took this to heart, and I made it my mission to complete. I don't want to get too emotional because that doesn't need to be documented on camera, but I did just want to give a few shout-outs to some of the people that I wouldn't have been able to fulfill my mission without. Kelly, Casey, and Chris, thank you all for pushing me to let my fun and my wild side out. I needed these nights more than you all will ever know, and I'm so thankful to have shared so many fun, dancing-filled memories with you three. I will miss you all more than you know, and I cannot wait to see what all of our futures hold. I can only imagine all of the shenanigans that we would have partaken in if our time together wasn't cut short this last semester. I love you guys, and I can't wait for our next adventures together. Leah, Nicole, and Peyton, the three people that I can always count on for ice cream and dinner dates. You three are the best things that college could have possibly given me. You all somehow were able to fill the void when I was feeling homesick or just needing a little extra love. Being able to spend nights laughing, telling stories, and eating way too much food with you all are some of my favorite memories over the last 4 years. You guys don't know how much of an impact that you made on my life, and I will forever be grateful for you. I can't wait to see what your futures hold. Each of you are so bright, and I can only hope to continually be a part of your journeys. If I were to talk about each person that I've exchanged memories with, we would be here all day, and no one wants that. So just know how touched I've been by all of the ADPI events, shop books, pre-games, friendsgivings, study dates, and random nights that involved a little too much singing and dancing. Each of you had made an impact on my life in so many different ways, and I will forever be thankful for that. I owe a huge thank you to each of you for helping shape me into the person that I am. I've enjoyed my college years so much, and sometimes a little too much, but now it's time to hit up Big Girl World. I'll always be here if anyone needs me. Here's to closing a chapter and opening the biggest one yet. I love you guys. Bye.
You guys are staying healthy. We just have a quick message for you.
These past 4 years have been nothing short of crazy, unexpected, and amazing.
During our years at WKU, we have been involved in a multitude of things, yet maintain an unstoppable friend group.
We have made some of our favorite memories together that are not limited to
spring break trips amid Daytona Bike Week and a pandemic,
late night frat hopping, even though we got a little too old for it.
We're eating China Express while playing For the Girls on a random night of the week.
These memories are only special because of the people in them.
Thank you, ADPI, for bringing us our best friends and our future bridesmaids.
As we move on to the next chapter of life, we remain confident that our friendship is not limited to 4 years of college, but for the rest of our lives.
Hello, sisters. I'm so excited to be able to do this. Despite the circumstances, it's been really great to reflect on my time in ADPI and how thankful I am for every single person and memory that's come into my life over the past 4 years. And I know that this means something different to every person. For me, it has always been about investing in other women and having someone invest in you as well. And I think there's something really important and special about being in a prep ceremony and having another woman advocate on your behalf and for your strengths and give you that promise of sisterhood and friendship. And then I think it's even more special to be able to offer that to other women as the years go on and see women that you've invested in become strong leaders in the chapter and on campus. And I know that leaving our class has had a small part in that, but it will continue long past us because it started long before us. So that's really, really special for me to see. I'm so thankful for every single opportunity I've had in this chapter. I have served in several different leadership positions and been on different committees, and that's all due to your confidence in me as a leader. And I can truly say that I've become a more confident person and a more capable leader since starting my freshman year in ADPI. And that has been so special to me to grow in that way. I'm especially thankful for the people it's brought into my life. It's brought me roommates and best friends and mentors, and none of that would be possible without the chapter. Of course, I have to shout out my friends from my Alpha class who have stuck with me and have stuck together and have a group message that we love to chat in to this day, with Dana, Morgan, Catherine, and Claire. And then, of course, my Diamond family. A lot of them have graduated, but I'm still so proud of Chloe and Ellie and Sailor and the rest of my family, my extended family. And I'm so grateful for you all and for all the memories that we've had. I don't have a lot else to add other than I'm really proud to have been in ADPI the past 4 years. It was something I wanted more than anything coming into college, was to be in this chapter. And as time has gone on, I have been so encouraged, and at the same time, I've shared disappointment due to the things that I've experienced in the chapter, and that's all part of it. That's normal. Every person that's come before you has experienced those moments of discouragement. But I'm just always reminded of how strong and intelligent and capable we are as a group of women. And I am so thankful that I had the opportunity to be a part of this 4 years ago, and that I was able to have a small part in investing in you all while I was here. So thank you all so much. If you ever need anything, I'm here, and I'm excited to come back and see all the wonderful things that you're going to continue to do. Bye!
Hey sisters, it's Morgan. I just wanted to drop in and say thanks for the memories, and I love Epsilon Delta. I can't wait to see how you all grow in the future.
Yes, second to what Morgan said, thank you so much, ADPI and Epsilon Delta, for bringing me some of my fondest memories here within my 3 years of ADPI. I'll miss y'all so much, and I just can't wait to see how y'all grow and flourish in the future. We love you.
I had the opportunity to share my story with many of you, a story that when looking back on it truly exemplifies what it means to be an Alpha Delta Pi and what it means to be the first. Even before I was a member of Alpha Delta Pi, so many of you were the first to make an impact on my life as a college student. And now, as a senior that is preparing to move 5 hours away from WKU, I know that you will continue to do so. From the very beginning, this sorority has meant so much more than the letters that we share. It's more about the community and the relationships that we have formed throughout our college years. I know that these relationships will be forever, no matter the distance between us. From this point forward, my prayer is Genesis 31:49. May the Lord keep watch between you and me when we are away from each other. Although this is not the way that any of us imagined that we would be saying our see you laters, I wanted to make sure that I said thank you. So, to 1633 Chestnut Street, the foreman, and the sisters that I love dearly, thank you so much for being my home away from home for the past 3 years. Thank you for encouraging me to take leaps of faith, all while supporting me and loving me every step of the way. Thank you for helping me be the best version of myself so that I can be a better student, sister, servant, and friend. Most importantly, thank you for encouraging me to be the first in whatever I undertake. As I conclude, I wanted to share this quote from the speech that I gave during recruitment because I feel as though it is applicable not only to PNMs, but also to each of you, regardless of what stage of life you are currently experiencing. No matter the path that you choose from this point on, I leave you with this. Be the first to show a helping hand to a stranger. Be the first to stand up for what you believe in. Be the first to take the road less traveled. Be the first to make a difference. You can follow footsteps or you can make footprints. The decision is yours. I love you all.
Hey you all, it's Catherine here. I hope you guys are doing well. I missed you. Kind of jealous that you get to go back in the fall and see each other again, but it's a little bittersweet. Anyways, I was thinking about what I wanted to do for my senior speech and was thinking about, okay, freshman year, what was I like? Like, what was I thinking? And I vividly remember, so I thought I'd share with you guys, just the mindset that I had that kind of changed the next 4 years for me. I remember being so nervous by all the upperclassmen, even to just walk into the house by myself, because I was like, I don't know anybody. And I was like, I came home and I was like, Mom, you know what? I don't ever want to like be able to walk into that house and not be able to know that person's name for any of the girls. It's like a sorority of 100 and something women. And I believe I should know everybody if I'm gonna call my sister. So that's kind of what got me started on a roll, and I just, that ties in because my biggest advice was just to get involved. I mean, fall 18 ladies, you guys let me be your mom for a semester, and that was probably, you guys heard me say that all the time, but also just to not get lost in ADPI either, but to be yourself and represent ADPI well, but as well as yourself well, out on campus. Besides that, I was just gonna give a few shout outs, but I'm kind of nervous because I don't want to forget anybody. But fall 18, first of all, thanks for letting me be your mom. That was probably one of my favorite experiences, just being an ADPI and getting to invest in you guys. Not only that, but like my H4 gals, my Gamma Chi's, the girls I worked at with Preston or at St. Thomas, literally anybody, my family for going on snow cone dates. I don't know. You got a lot of good girls in that sisterhood, and just being able to meet everybody and invest in everybody for those 4 years was really one of my favorite things. But you guys know me. I'll be in Lexington for the next 3 years, between there and Louisville. So seriously, if you need anything, just reach out, call, text. I'd love to still stay involved, and I just want you guys to know that I'm lucky that I do get a community of pretty awesome women to come back to, hopefully, for future homecomings. So, bye. Love ya.
Losing our brains, hard up against change. All the old dogs and the magician. Now I see you are in the boat in 2x2s. Only the heart that we have for a tool we could use. And the varicose quarters are hard to get used to. Love weighs the hull down with its weight. But the wood is tired and the wood is old. And we'll make it fine if the weather holds. But if the weather holds, will it miss the pole?